Today we are going to study SR latch using NAND gate. SR latch using NAND gate is also called as a active low latch. In this circuit, cross connected NAND gate is used. As compared to SR latch using NOR gate, here one difference is that S is connected to first NAND gate and R is connected to second NAND gate. And as NAND gate is used here, first of all, see the truth table of this NAND gate. In NAND gate, one of the input is a 0. One of the input is a 0. In that case, output is a high. And when both the inputs are 1, 1, in that case output is 0. That in NAND gate output is always complement of the A dot B complement, or we may say the complement of the AND is nothing but NAND. Here S is your set and R is your reset inputs. First of all, see S is equal to 0 and R is equal to, when S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 0, in that case both the inputs of this, as one of the input to the NAND gate 1 is 0, then what happens? One of the input is a 0, Q try to become 1. As one of the input to this second gate is also 0, therefore Q bar also try to get 1 over here, and therefore here Q is equal to 1 and Q dash is also equal to 1, and this stage is not allowed. This is also called undetermined stage and should be avoided, because in latch output should be opposite to the one another. Second stage, consider this S is equal to 0 and this R dash equal to 1. Here S equal to 0 and R equal to 1. One of the input to this first NAND gate is a 0. By this truth table, one of the input is a 0. Output is 1. This 1 is applied to the second gate. Both the inputs are 1, 1. Output is 0. Means here Q becomes 1 and Q dash becomes 0. Okay, complement of this becomes 0. Next, suppose you are taking this S is equal to 1, R is equal to 0. S is equal to 1, R is equal to 0, then what happens? One of the input to the second gate is a 0, output becomes 1, and this 1 is applied to first gate. As both the inputs to the first gate is 1, 1, output Q becomes 0 by this rule. In NAND gate, when both the inputs are 1 1, output is 0. Okay, means S is equal to 1, Q becomes 0 and Q bar, in that case Q bar becomes 1, and this is our reset state. When Q is equal to 1, this is our set state. Suppose here we are keeping both the inputs high, both the inputs S dash is equal to 1, R dash is equal to 1, then what happens? And suppose we are considering the initial values as it is, 0 and 1, whatever the initial values over there. Then one of the input is 1, one of the input is 1, and this previous value is applied to this gate, that is S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1, then this becomes, Q becomes 0. This 0 is applied to this, then 1 and 0, it becomes 1, 0, one of the input is 0 and second is 1, we are getting output as a 1. Means our previous value is 1 and current value is also, Q bar chi current value and present value both are the same. Means previous value upon kai consider keli hoti 1, current value kai hai 1. Means there is no change. Previous value and the current value both are equal. Suppose we are considering now the previous value Q as 1 and Q dash is equal to 0. Okay. Then what about the next values we are going to see? Here Q bar is equal to 0 and Q is equal to 1. Here one of the input to the first gate is a 0, therefore our new value Qn plus 1 becomes 1, and as this 1 is applied to the second gate, here R is equal to 1, this Q is equal to 1, then Qn plus 1, the next value we are getting over here, this again becomes 0, both the inputs are 1 in the NAND gate, output is a 0. And therefore, even if you are considering the Q as a 0 or Q as a 1, there is no difference at all, and that's why this stage is called as a no change. Means here suppose Q is equal to 0, it remains 0 as it is. If it is 1, then it remains 1 as it is. Means 0 and 1 is the previous stage, or 1 or 0 is the previous stage, it remains as it is. Thus, here 0 0, that is output try to remains 1 1, it is avoid, it should be avoided or undetermined stage. When input is a 0 1, output is set to 1, it becomes a set stage. When s is equal to 1, output is a 0, then it is a reset stage. And when both the inputs are 1 1, output is a no change, and that is also known as a memory. Means whatever the signal available on that circuit, that remains as it is, and this condition is also known as a memory stage. Therefore, when both are 1 1, no change, 0, output is a 1, that is a set, 1, output is a 0, that is your reset stage, and 0 0 invalid stage. And this both the input is a 1, that is also considered as a used for data storage. Thank you.